My name is Stefania Vigone and welcome here to my small place for my homemade gnocchi recipe. Today it's a recipe, it's a house recipe, so it's from my grandmother Rina that started to work very young and she was coming from the mountain. So we have a lot of recipes in our family that are using a lot of milk and cheese because she was coming from the countryside, they had a lot of cows. And so they were cooking with what they were having available, so the milk, the cheese, and the potatoes. So let's start to make our gnocchi. I will show you some techniques. This is normally a recipe that in Italy is on Thursday, so they say Thursday gnocchi. We will need 1 kilo of boiled potatoes and 500 grams of wheat flour. Later on you will find all the description, and some salt to prepare. Some other people, they prepare with egg, but in our family we prepare it without egg. So it's gonna be also totally vegan. Okay, so there are two ways you can work the potato. So you can just make like this with your fork. These are boiled potatoes, so you wait that they are not too hot, of course, otherwise you're gonna burn yourself. Or, to be easy, you can even use this one. So you just put the potato in and you just press and the potato will come out. Okay, so this is the two ways you can use to make the gnocchi, okay? So we will take the potatoes, go on a little bit working it in order to make it nice and soft. This was something that in the family was made with all the generations, so the grandma together with mom and the children. So you add some flour, some salt, and you just start working the gnocchi. They need to be soft, so the less flour you put, the softer the gnocchi will be. Okay, so you just start to mix them. You put some flour on the surface so that it's going to be easier. So they don't need to be worked too much because it's a soft consistency. Okay. This is very relaxing, stress releasing. Okay, some more flour. I will take part of it. Sorry, let's put it like this so you can see. And we start to make small rolls like this. Another one. They are homemade, okay? So the size, it's not really matter. Eh? So you start cutting them like this. So every region has a different different tradition, right? Okay, so in my house, the gnocchi, it's not a gnocchi if you don't do this. So you take the gnocchi, you just pass it like this on the fork, and this will create this small shape. You see? Like this. So the gnocchi will have a hole and then some stripes on the other side. And that's it. Our gnocchi are ready. We can take them and go to boil. Okay, so these are the ingredients that we will need for our today's recipe. So the gnocchi that we just made with potatoes, and then you can use actually any kind of cheese that you like, but in this case I prepared a medium soft cheese that can be fontina or delebbio, some soft cheese like mozzarella, some gorgonzola cheese that can be substituted if you cannot find it with any blue cheese, and some good grana padano cheese. Then we will need some milk, of course salt and pepper. Okay, the ingredients later are listed with the quantities. Okay, so let's start. The first thing we will do is put some salt in the boiling water. Okay, and we put the gnocchi inside the water. This is a very soft pasta, so it doesn't need so much time. In this moment we will switch on the fire and we will place some milk in our pan. This will help the gnocchi to melt, and then we can take our cheese. Lebbio cheese, mozzarella, gorgonzola, and later on we will add the parmesan. I want to wait. Okay, so what we need to do is start just to make the cheese melt and get the right consistency to dress our gnocchi. In the meantime, gnocchi are boiling and you see they are coming on the surface. And then in this moment you will add some parmesan. So for those who don't like too much salt, you can go like this without adding salt, because actually this sauce will be quite tasty. But for the one that, of course, need a little bit more of salt, this is the moment in which you can add just a pinch. And you see, the sauce is already melting. All these nice cheese are melting together. We will take a little bit of black pepper. Okay, this is the moment in which we will take out. So I will switch off the fire, take the gnocchi out of the pan. These are big gnocchi, eh? Okay. And then you mix them with the cheese sauce. That's it. Let's go here. Gnocchi ai quattro formaggi. Nonnarina style, so my grandmother style. You see all the mozzarella is leaking this very beautiful cheese sauce that is dripping from the pan. If you want a little bit of black pepper on top and a little bit more of parmesan cheese. And my grandma's recipe for the gnocchi is done. And gnocchi quattro formaggi, my grandmother's Rina recipe, is done for you. I hope you enjoy. Buon appetito. And nonna, ti voglio bene. Ciao.